This car evokes a lot of emotions. The Lotus Eletre is among the first electric models from the car maker. Expected to hit the market next year, Lotus Eletre packs performance and features of a super hypercar. But that's just a drop in the ocean. The car packs a lot more, which we will be going through in today's video. Let's get started with the design of the car. The Lotus Eletre has a sports car-like front end with a low and short hood with aero work, a large active air intake at the bottom, and a muscular bumper. There are ultra-slim technical light clusters in the front that contain DRLs and turn indicators. The matrix headlights are located underneath and seem to be concealed. Lower below, whether the EV is stationary or system detects a need to minimize drag when moving, the active grille with the triangular design stays closed. They open as necessary to cool the batteries, front brakes, and electric motors. The Lotus Eletre has powerful shoulders and a sleek glass region on the sides. It includes camera-based virtual mirrors, which provide benefits such as decreased vehicle width, drag, and wind noise. The door handles, which are flush with the doors, also help with aerodynamics and give the SUV a classy look. The Eletre has a deeply sloped windshield, a concave surface, a short full-width taillight, a split rear spoiler, and a hexagonal license plate space at the back. When the ignition is switched on, two LiDAR modules, one in front and one in back, emerge from the roof. LiDAR modules are also present on the sides and are concealed when not in use. Lotus claims that the Eletre has conventional mirrors in areas where local rules prohibit virtual mirrors. Having talked about the different exterior features that the Eletre packs, let's now get to the inside and see what the interior looks like and what cool features it packs. Lotus worked with the Danish textile manufacturer Quadrat to design the interior of the Eletre. The inside makes extensive use of long-lasting handcrafted microfibers and wool blend textiles. Carbon fiber covers the hard touch points, and Lotus has also employed recycled fiber in several locations. However, as with most new automobiles, digital real estate is the new EV showpiece. To begin with, there is no typical digital cluster. The Eletre, on the other hand, features the ribbon of technology. A ribbon-sized screen less than 30 millimeters high that displays critical vehicle information to the driver and co-driver. A 15.1-inch landscape-oriented OLED infotainment screen lies between the two ribbons and automatically folds flat when not in use. The Lotus Eletre will also come equipped with an augmented reality heads-up display. What's noteworthy is that unlike many other brands, Lotus has not bestowed physical buttons on the history books. Physical buttons may be used to operate features like as door lock, unlock, front and rear defoggers, gear selection, and danger lights. The steering wheel also has controls for cruise control and navigating the ribbon screen. Different degrees of braking energy regeneration are controlled by paddles located behind the steering wheel. Lotus claims that in regions other than China, the panoramic glass sunroof is an optional feature. Apart from the glass sunroof, let's take a look at other features that this car packs. Lotus recognizes that Chinese clients are more tech-savvy than typical Lotus purchasers in other regions, and it is designing an interior to suit their expectations. Techies will be able to immerse themselves in the technology, whilst driving aficionados will be able to concentrate only on the necessities. The Lotus Eletre is equipped with a LiDAR sensor, which assists with different driver assist functions and improves the EV's active safety capabilities. The electric SUV, like the Volvo EX90, features LiDAR with Luminar technology. Many sophisticated driver assistance systems, such as adaptive cruise control, traffic sign information, cross-traffic warning, collision mitigation, lane change, keep assist, and many more functions are enabled by the LiDAR technology. By the time it goes on sale, the Eletre will be capable of level 4 autonomous driving. The Lotus Eletre will also come equipped with 5G connection, allowing for ultra-fast OTA upgrades. 5G connection is critical for V2X, vehicle-to-everything, communications, and precise positioning to work properly. Lotus has long been known for its driver-focused automobiles. It's ironic that Lotus is using technology like LiDAR to divert attention away from the driver. However, since the Eletre will be offered in areas such as China and Europe, where there is a growing emphasis on autonomous driving, Lotus has opted to play by the rules rather than against them, even if it means altering its fundamental focus. Before we can see which platform the car has been built on, please give the video a thumbs up if you're enjoying it. With that done, let's see more about the new platform. Lotus claims that its EV will be built on a new electric premium architecture, EPA, that will be unveiled in April 2021. This platform enables C-plus to E-plus class EVs with wheelbases ranging from 2,899 to 3,100 mm and a variety of battery capacities, motors, component layouts and sophisticated driving systems. According to Chinese media, the platform is connected to the Geely SEA open source architecture that underpins the Zeekr 001, Smart #1 and Volvo EX90. On paper, the headline stats are extremely spectacular. The Eletre 800-volt design would enable a 350-kilowatt DC fast charger to charge its battery for 248 miles of range in about 20 minutes. The SUV features two electric motors, one on each axle, making it an all-wheel drive vehicle. Lotus provides three Eletre models, Eletre, Eletre S and Eletre R. The Eletre and Eletre S share a 450 kilowatt, 603 horsepower, and 710 Nm, 524 pound foot torque power plant. They have a 0 to 62 mile per hour sprint time of 4.5 seconds and a peak speed of 160 mile per hour. The engine of the Eletre R produces 675 kilowatt, 905 horsepower, and 985 Nm, 726 pound foot of torque. The high-end model can go from 0 to 62 mile per hour in 2.95 seconds and peak out at 165 mile per hour. The Lotus Eletre is equipped with a 112 kilowatt hour battery pack that provides a WLTP range of 373 miles in the Eletre and Eletre S versions and 304 miles in the Eletre variant. The EPA estimated range statistics might be about 300 and 250 miles, respectively. Lotus Cars has verified a maximum AC charging power of 22 kilowatts. However, the entire charging duration has yet to be revealed. The highest DC charging power has not been released. However, it has verified that a 10 to 80% DC fast charging session takes just 20 minutes. Lotus Cars has suggested that it would employ CATL's Qilin battery in the Eletre, at least in Chinese units. Qilin is the third generation of CATL's cell-to-pack CTP technology, and CATL claims it can give a range of more than 1,000 kilometers, 621 miles, in a breeze. For their lithium NMC batteries built using its newest CTP technology, the business claims a record-breaking volume utilization efficiency of 72% and an energy density of 255 watt-hours per kilogram. Fast charging from 10% to 80% takes just 10 minutes. The new battery technology has been thoroughly detailed on the worldwide CATL website. CATL anticipates that the CTP 3.0 batteries, Qilin batteries, will be mass-produced and used in the first EVs on the market in 2023. The Lotus Eletre is equipped with a 5-link rear suspension. At launch, optional features such as brake-based torque vectoring, adaptive air suspension, active anti-roll bars, carbon ceramic brakes, and rear-wheel steering will be available. Dynamic torque vectoring will be offered as well. The EV has 5 driving modes that vary the steering, suspension, motor, and pedal response: range, tour, sport, off-road, and individual. Moving on, let's take a look at some of the cars the Eletre will be competing with. Lotus, which is focused on performance, will not position the Lotus Eletre as a direct competitor to any current electric SUV. "We will not benchmark any rivals," Lotus Technology CMO Qin Yan told Autohome during a 2021 Guangzhou Auto Show interview. He said that the future electric SUV will have few competition and that the corporation would pitch it as a premium model compared to the few competitors that exist. "It will be a driver's automobile as opposed to usual made-in-China versions that prioritize rear seat passengers." Given its placement, the Lotus Eletre will appeal to Tesla Model X, BMW iX, and Mercedes EQE SUV buyers. Lotus is a performance brand, thus the Model X Plaid, EQE AMG SUV and iX M60 should be the primary targets. Qing Yan stated that the corporation would need to invest heavily in marketing ahead of the EV blitz. It will almost certainly need to build new company-owned showrooms and an online purchasing system in key international markets such as the EU, the UK and China, as well as launch new brand campaigns and prepare for greater level of after-sales service demands or standards. Lastly, let's now talk about production and when will the Eletre be released. The Lotus Eletre began production on July 15, 2022. However, Lotus Eletre customer deliveries will commence in China, Europe and the United Kingdom in the first half of 2023. Reservations are now being accepted on the Lotus official website for €2,500. The Eletre, Eletre S and Eletre R are priced at £89,500, £104,500 and £120,000 respectively in the United Kingdom. The Lotus Eletre is expected to be a highly sporty SUV with exceptional driving characteristics and on-road performance. It will appeal to buyers seeking even more performance than the Polestar 3 and the BMW iX M60, as well as those seeking a practical daily driver that feels almost as thrilling as a sports vehicle. And we don't just mean in terms of statistics. What do you think about this super hypercar? Please let us know about what you think in the comments section. Be sure to check out the videos being displayed on your screen. Until the following video, peace, I am out.